now? A pronoun is a word that is used instead of a noun. Okay, the examples of pronouns are I, you, she, he, him. All these are all called as pronouns. Okay, like we'll go ahead and continue. Can someone tell me, have we completed worksheet 2, exercise A? Have we completed this exercise? Can you just see and tell, page number 24?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then we will move ahead to exercise B. Okay, underline the pronoun in the following sentences and write the noun it stands for. The first one is done to guide you. Okay. First one, what you have to do here is you have to write down which is the pronoun and for in place of which noun is this particular pronoun used for. You have to write both. For example, the first one is shown here. Everybody liked the painting. It was beautiful. Okay, so here the pronoun is it, right? They have already written it. And what does this it stand for? It stands for the pronoun painting. Yes, okay, it stands for the pronoun painting. So they have written it and then they've put a small dash and they've written painting. So it is a pronoun and it is used instead of the noun painting. Okay, did you all understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, very good. Okay, now turn your book to page number 25.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Lingeshwar.
Nothing, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Okay, now turn your book to page number 25. The second sentence, the girls danced gracefully. They had practiced well. Okay, so now here, which is the pronoun that is used in the second sentence? Which is the pronoun?
They, ma'am.
Write down T.
They, ma'am.
Why?
They, ma'am.
Here, capital
T-H-E-Y.
They. Okay, write down they. And then put a small dash. Now, who does they represent? Which is the noun that they represents here?
Gracefully, ma'am.
Not gracefully. Gracefully is an adjective. It is not a noun. Which is the noun here? Why have they used they here? Instead of which noun have they used? It is?
Girl.
Very good. They have used
girl, ma'am.
Instead of girls. Okay, so girls is the noun.
Girl.
Girls, they have
used
they. Okay? Write this down. You have to write in the second sentence in the dash that is here. You have to write T-H-E-Y. They. Okay. They is a pronoun.
More or less.
Okay. Do not write full sentence, children. Do not write down the full sentence. You just have to write capital T-H-E-Y. They. Put a small dash and write G-I-R-L-S. Girls. Okay, they is the pronoun and they represents the girl.
Girls.
Everyone is finished. Varun has already shown a thumbs up. The rest of you all, have you completed?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, very good. Okay, now moving on to the third sentence.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, Sonu.
I'm Pratusha, ma'am.
Yes, tell me, Pratusha.
In first line, what I have to write, ma'am?
On page number 25, in the first line here, okay? In the first dash that is written, you will write capital T-H-E-Bay. Okay? And then, small dash, and then write girl. G-I-R-L-S. Girls. Okay? Only this one you have to write in that dash. Okay? Now, next. Third sentence, Neeta went to the station. She wanted to meet her aunt. Okay?
She, ma'am.
She, very good. She Write down S H G. Third sentence below you have the dash, right? There, write down S H E. She is the pronoun, and this pronoun is used in which noun?
Meeta ma'am.
Very good.
Meeta.
Meeta ma'am.
Capital M I T A. Meeta.
Capital M and capital I. Capital M.
Capital M I T A. Meeta. Meeta is a proper noun. It's a special name. So you have to begin it with a capital letter. Okay. Okay, all of you have finished? Yes, very good. Lingeshwar is completed.
Kushal also finished, ma'am.
Kushal also is finished. Very good. Varun also is finished. Okay, now moving on to the next one. Fourth sentence. Krish was very sad. He had lost his favorite pen. So which is the pronoun used here?
He, ma'am.
Very good. Pronoun is he. And what is the noun? Which is
Krish.
Very good.
Krish, ma'am.
Krish. Okay, you have to write he is a pronoun and he is used instead of the noun Krish. Okay, so he dash and Krish. Capital K R I S H. Krish. Capital K R I S H. Krish. Capital K R I S H. Krish. Yes, very good one. Okay. Now, next one, fifth sentence. Mother returned from office. She was very tired. So, which is the pronoun here?
She, ma'am.
Very good.
She, ma'am.
Which is the noun that she is used instead of?
Mother.
Very good. Write down M O T H E R. Mother. M O T H E R. Mother. Okay. She is a pronoun, and that pronoun is used instead of the noun mother. Okay. Yes. Very good, Varun. M-O-T-H-E-R, mother. Yes, very good, Soom. Okay, now next one, sixth one. The deer ran fast. It was frightened of the tiger. So, which is the pronoun here?
It, ma'am.
Very good. Yes. And it is used instead of which noun here?
Deer,
very good. It is deer, not the tiger. Deer noun is used instead of. Okay. It is used instead of the pronoun deer. I'm sorry, instead of the noun deer.
Ma'am, seventh one, flower.
Seventh one, the flowers were arranged in a vase. They looked beautiful. So, which is the pronoun here?
They.
Yeah, ma'am.
So, ma'am. Good. Right down.
Yes. Ma'am.
Right down.
Excuse me, ma'am.
They.
T-H-E-Y-L.
T-H-E-Y-L.
T-H.
T-H-E-Y, they. And they is used instead of which noun here?
Flower, ma'am.
Write down flowers. F-L-O W E R S, flowers. F L O W E R S, flowers. Yes, very good one. Okay, F L O.
Ma'am, flower is a noun.
W E R S, flowers. Okay, now next.
Ma'am, flower is a noun.
Okay, now next. Eighth one. Rahul wrote neatly. His handwriting was very good. So, which is the pronoun?
Is man.
Yes. H-I-S. His.
Rahul man.
H-U-L. Rahul. Capital R-A. H-U-L. Rahul. Capital R A.
Finished, ma'am.
Very good. The ones are finished. We'll give time for the others. Okay. Thank you, children. Yes, R A H U L. Rahul. Rahul.
Finished, ma'am.
Okay. Yes. Very good.
Finished, ma'am.
Check your answers if you've written everything correctly.
Finished, ma'am.
Okay. Second one, you should have written they.
Ma'am, finished.
Okay. Third one, she dash Meeta. Fourth one, he dash Krish. Fifth one, she dash mother. Sixth one, it dash deer. Okay, remember, though you have both the animals deer and tiger, in this sentence, it represents the deer. Okay, not the tiger, it represents the deer only. Next, seventh one, they and flowers. And eighth one, his and Rahul. Okay. Hope all of you have completed till that.
Yes, miss. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Worksheet 3. Read the following passage carefully. Okay. Okay. Neeta sits down at the breakfast table. Good morning, mother. Good morning, Neeta. What would you like to eat? I would like to have a tomato sandwich, mother. Mother gives a tomato sandwich. Thank you, mother. Neeta eats her sandwich. It was very tasty, mother. Can I have a glass of milk, please? Yes, you may. Thank you, mother. Okay, so here you see the conversation that happens between a mother and her daughter. Okay, so what is the daughter's name? She is Neeta. Okay, she comes to the breakfast table and what does the mother ask? What would you like to have for breakfast? Okay, so what does Neeta say? Please also notice all the words.
Ma'am, she has sandwich.
Yes. Okay, so she says, I would like to have a tomato sandwich. Okay, so mother gives a tomato sandwich. Once mother gives the tomato sandwich, what does Neeta say? What does Neeta say? She says, thank you.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
These are all words that you have to use in your everyday life. Okay, not just now and then. You have to use it every day. When you receive something from anyone, okay, it can be from your best friend or from your parents or from anyone. You have to reciprocate. You have to tell them, thank you very much. Okay. And when you're going to ask something from someone, you have to use the word. Which word will you use?
Excuse me.
Not excuse me. You will use the word
please.
Yes, you have to use the word please. Okay, when do you use excuse? When you're going, when you want to move ahead and someone is standing, that time you say, excuse me, may I move in the front, okay? Or when you sneeze, okay? Because sneeze is something which is right. When you sneeze suddenly, that time you say, excuse me. Okay?
My voice is breaking, ma'am.
Yes, that is because most of you all are unmuting yourselves. Okay, I've told you, do not unmute. Okay? Now, Neeta eats her sandwich. It was very tasty, mother. Can I have a glass of milk, please? Yes, you may. Thank you, mother. Okay, so these are the mannerisms that you need to learn. You have to also use it in your everyday life. Okay, next, turn your book to page number 26. Okay, now, tick the right answer for the situations given. What will you say? First one, when you meet your parents in the morning, okay, when you meet your parents in the morning, what do you say? Do you say good afternoon, good morning, or good evening?
Good morning, ma'am.
Very good, very good. But good morning, ma'am. Yes. First one, have three boxes like this. Good morning is the center one. Put a tick mark there. In the center box, put a tick mark. Okay, that is good morning. Okay, now second one, you want a piece of cake. So when you want a piece of cake, how will you ask someone? May I have a piece of cake? Give me a piece of cake, or I want a piece of cake. How will you ask someone? When you want something. Very good. Very good.
May I have
in the first one, put a tick mark. In the first box. In the first box here, you have to put a tick mark.
You should okay. Answer.
Second one. I'm sorry, third one. Your mother tells you a story. Okay, so when your mother tells you a story, how will you answer to her? Tell me another one. I want to hear one more. Or thank you, mother. It was a very interesting story. How will you tell her?
Thank you, mother.
Say thank you, mother. It was a very interesting
story.
Story. Yes, very good. So the third dash, the third box here, put a tick mark. Okay, put a tick mark in the third box. Okay, that is the right one. Next one, fourth one. You break your brother's favorite toy by mistake. Okay, if by mistake, when you break your brother's favorite toy, how will you tell him? It was not my mistake. Sorry, I didn't mean to do it, or I will not do it again. How will you tell? What will you tell him? Okay, now listen here. When you do something wrong, even
sorry.
Yes, very good. Okay. Yes, very good. Okay, so when you do something by mistake, first thing that you have to tell is, I am sorry. Okay, as soon as you say you are sorry, the other person's anger will be reduced by half. Okay, if he's really very angry with you, as soon as you say sorry, he will come down. His anger will come down. Okay, so what will you say? Sorry, I didn't mean to do it. Okay, that is the second one. So in the second box, put a tick mark. A tick mark in the middle box. Yes, very good. Okay. All of you have finished this? Yes. You know, just check your answer. So when you meet your parents in the morning, you will tell them good morning. That is a second box.
Excuse me, ma'am, please repeat.
I'm repeating, just listen, okay? And mark your answer. All the four. Okay, so for the first one, in the middle one, the second box, you should have put a tick mark saying good morning. Okay, second one, you want a piece of cake? You have to tick mark the first sentence. May I have a piece of cake? Okay, the first sentence should be ticked. Third one, the third sentence, you your mother
said,
what will you, how will you answer her? You will say, thank you, mother. Story. That is the third box you should have ticked.
Fourth one, sorry, man.
The fourth one, you break your brother's favorite toy by mistake.
Sorry, man.
Sit properly. Sit up, Munal. Go in front.
I didn't. Okay. Hope all of you
have
the four sentences. Yes. Now we'll move on to the next exercise. Okay. Exercise that is worksheet four. Okay. Once you have background noise, please do not unmute yourself. It is disturbing the class. Okay. Now the next worksheet, worksheet 4A. Read the words given below and change only one letter in each word to get the name of an animal or a bird. First one is done to guide you. Okay, they've already done one. The same way you have to follow for the rest. Okay, first word they have given boat, right? They have given the word boat. What have they changed? They've only changed B to G. So it becomes
boatman.
Boat. Okay, now second one. Okay, now second one. It is
boxman on beetroot, ma'am.
Don't change the entire word. Okay? Do not change the entire word. You have
to change
one letter. Okay, you have to change only one letter and make it into an animal. So if your B-O-X box, you can change B to F-O-X box.
Boxman. Boxman. Excuse me, ma'am. It's a foxman.
Yes, please write down. Okay. F O X. Next, third one. The word is carrot.
Man.
Very good. Instead of C, you will put a
carrot. Carrot, man.
A R R O T. Carrot. Write down third one. P-A-R-R-O-T. Parrot. P-A-R-R-O-T. Parrot. P-A-R-R-O-T. Fourth one, B-R-O-W. Pretty good. Write down C-R.
Crow.
Man. Yes, Nikhil.
What, ma'am? Third one
is parrot. P-A-R-R-O-T. Parrot. And the fourth one is crow. The bro, when you change B to C, it becomes crow. C-R-O-W. Crow.
C-R-O-W.
Okay, next one. L-A-M-P. Lamp.
Lamb. Lamb, ma'am.
Very good. M-B. Okay, instead of P here, you will change it to B.
Sheep. What is the 51?
No, no, rule. Oh, no, there. I'm going to be here.
Okay, there is
what it was kissing, man.
Mute everyone and I'll not let you all unmute yourself. Okay. I see that there is a noise behind. Please do not unmute.
What is the 50, man?
Yes, Aldrich. Fifth one is lamb. L-A-M-B. Okay, so the P you have to change it to B. Okay, next. Sixth one, sheet. Sheet.
Sheep, ma'am.
Very good. It is sheep. Write down S-H-E-E-P.
S-H-E-E-P.
Okay, sixth one is S-H-E-E-P. Sheep. Next one, seventh one, pen. P-E-N. Pen.
Pen.
Pen. Pen.
Pen.
P-E-N. Pen. Write down. H-E-N. Pen. Yes, very good, very good. Okay. Next, eighth one, you have fair. F-A-R-E. Fair.
Where, ma'am? Ma'am, what is the seventh one, ma'am?
A-R-E. Hey.
Okay. What is the seventh one?
Seventh one is
hen. Ma'am,
what is the seventh one?
Seventh one is hen. H-E-N, hen. Okay, next one, eighth one. Instead of fair, you will change F to H and it becomes a hair. Remember the hair in the tortoise story? Okay, you have to change it to hair. Sixth one, ninth one, house.
Mouse.
Mouse. So instead of H, you're going to write M.
Mouse.
M-O-U-S-E.
Mouse.
M-O-U-S-E.
M-O-U-S-E.
Excuse
me, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Excuse me, ma'am. What is the ninth one?
Ninth one is mouse. M-O-U-S-E. Mouse.
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am, what is... Tenth one, ma'am.
Tenth one is goose. Okay, instead of goose, instead of N, you're going to write G.
Go. Oh, nail polish and tongue sushi tame on the
goose. Goose. Okay, all of you have finished till here.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, very good. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Now I'm going to
excuse ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am.
Yes.
What is time to end, ma'am?
Okay, now only the name. Okay, I'm going to take the attendance. Abhinaya is here.
You can answer.
Ma'am, ma'am.
Ma'am, we all do breaking, ma'am.
1 minute.